Good morning, students of class 10. You are welcome back to the e-classes now. Here in English, we have a chapter, Nelson Mandela. There are many questions. And I have written three questions for your easy reference. Let me read out the questions. One, two, three. First, let me read out the question. What does courage mean to Mandela? And number two, how did Mandela's hunger for freedom change his life? Question number three, what according to Mandela is true freedom? So now there are three questions. Now you look at the answer. Let me read out the answer now for your easy reference. Courage has a wider and deeper meaning to Mandela. It is not only limited to physical act of bravery and boldness, but according to Mandela, it means victory over fear. It is our mental strength that helps us in becoming really brave. A brave man is not he who is never afraid, but he who conquers fear. That is number one. And number two, let me read the answer now. First, let me read out the question again. How did Mandela's hunger for freedom change his life? His hunger for freedom changed his life, his desire for freedom of his people to live their life with dignity means respect, and self-respect was his aim of life. It changed him from a timid means a person who easily gets afraid, from a timid young man into a bold one. Bold means brave. It made him a rebel, a homeless person, and a crusader. Crusader means a fighter, a freedom fighter, for freedom. Now let me read out question number three. What according to Mandela is true freedom? Answer, according to him, when he was a boy, freedom for him meant to run freely in the field and swim in the stream. As a young man, he wanted basic and honorable freedom. Honorable freedom means to have a job, a family, and he realized that true freedom means freedom not to be obstructed or stopped or hindered in leading a lawful and a dignified life. So there are three questions for your easy references. Now in our next class I'll give some questions to be continued. Two stories of flying, about the black aeroplane and about the seagull. So we'll talk about that in our next class, and some questions I'll give you for your easy reference. That's all for today. You can take out the screenshot, or you can take the screenshot and you can copy it out, or learn at home properly. You know the story. This is only for your reference. So that's all for today.